My name is Nick Robinson. I'm the technical manager for Solo Rescue. I'm going to give you a brief history about the company real quick. We're part of a larger, a conglomerate company based in Zoom called Sandberg Development. Sandberg Development is a little technology company. The main one being Aimpoint, that makes the red dot sights. Cameroos makes medical devices. And Rental Disc, which makes pop washers. So Rental Disc is a company that manufactures this machine for us. It used to be part of a larger line of dishwashers. They decided to separate it out and focus on just fire rescue services. So this machine is the only machine in the line for Rescue and Pelotech, which is a company my card has on it. That's basically just another subsidiary of Sandberg Development under Rental Disc. So these machines are heavy duty, designed to work with all your SCBA gear. It was originally developed back in 2012 with the help of a firefighter in Sweden. He bought a used dishwasher and tried to wash it on his own, and it didn't quite work out that well. So he got with our company. We developed this specifically for that purpose. And since 2012, about 75% of Swedish fire departments have these units. So. Lifespan is determined to probably be about 15, 20 years, maybe even longer. So there's no real resale at this point, which is why we're moving out to new markets. We sold about 25 machines to South Korea recently. We're moving into Great Britain, Australia, all over the world. We just started selling here back in 2018, and we got about 30 machines in the market in different states here in the U.S. Your counterparts in Boston have two machines. They were one of the first ones to get it. So. They're sort of pushing the clean cat concept in that way. So, it's a very simple machine, very easy to use. You use hot water, a little bit of detergent, and there's a rotating basket inside that moves the equipment around as it washes. I'm just going to point out a couple things on the inside real quick before we get started. Right now we've got this is called our fill and our rinse line, which has nozzles at the top, side, and bottom. We've got our wash arms that are on the sides here. That are fixed and they wash as the basket rotates. I'm going to film right in here. Right in here, there's a water level sensor that senses the water level, the little white plug right there. You got a heater in this tank, the booster heater. Down at the bottom, you can see the drain sieve where any debris will get caught, rocks, grass, gravel, anything like that. When you're cleaning the machine, you drain it. You can always use a wet vac to reach in there and get your residual junk out the bottom if you need to. If you can reach it with your hand, you can lift it out that way. Best practice is always use nitrile gloves or something. That way you're not re-exposing yourself to the carcinogens in the water after it starts to get dirty. We've got some rollers here for the basket. The center shaft rotates here right in the middle. And there's a vent in the back to let steam escape.
Does it reuse the water each time?
Or? Yes, it does. Right here is the overflow, where the overflow water will drain out of. Basically, what you have is there's 29 gallons of water in this tank. It's going to fill up all the way to the sensor right there. It's a manual drain. So what we say is you get about 5 to 10 washes, depending on how dirty the equipment is. And once the water's dirty enough, then we go ahead and drain it out. Some good indicators are this white plug in the back. If you can't see that white plug through the water, that's a good indication there's enough particulate to go ahead and drain it. Also, eventually the water will cover that white sensor right in front, and if you can't see it through the water, then go ahead and dump your water out. So the water will get visibly dirty as you wash. The reason it's okay to wash with this gray water is that we're getting a fresh water rinse each cycle. So that rinse and fill line is going to rinse with 1.6 gallons of water each cycle. Going to rinse everything down off the equipment into the tank, all the soap, dirt, and all that down in the water. That's basically how we test our unit, is we take samples of the water to determine how much carcinogen is getting off. What else we got? So basically, that is...
So it's basically a big dishwasher.
Yeah, basically the big dishwasher, ruggedized sort of for the SCBA services. So this is a loading table. You don't want to stand on it or sit on it, but it's heavy duty. The other parts that go in here is the tank grid.
You really can't put anything in here backwards, it only goes in one way. There's a couple of folded metal pieces right here to hold it up. You can force it in, but it will not, you will not be able to get anything else in there.
We don't gotta take all this off to drain it, right?
No, this is just, only time you'll take these things out is when you clean it. And basically the cleaning consists of taking all the parts that we have out now. You're gonna wanna have a water hose or something close by, maybe that'll reach over to here. Cleaning really entails just rinsing all the surfaces, top, sides, bottom, and inside, and let it drain out. You don't wanna use any detergent to clean it because detergent will cause foaming. And that's really about it. You can use a scrub brush, a long handle scrub brush. If you got some grass or something stuck somewhere, just scrub it off. And I spray it down real well, let it drain out, and that's it.
All right, perfect.
All right, so we got the tank grid goes in, then we got the basket wheel. It's got a print on there, just slide it, rotate it till it drops. Then we got several accessories here. I'll tell you what these are. We basically got three things, or four things. This is we call it standard basket. Standard heavy duty basket. It's gonna slide out on a glider in order to load. It's real simple. What you wanna do is, this is your loading table. So I usually say bring it out to about here and then rotate it so it's loaded. If you bring it out to here, you're gonna hit that bar when you're going back. So you have to lift up on it. So that's just bring it out to about the edge of the door and that's where you'll leave it. How you can slide it in, back in easily. What you will notice is that when we close the door, it's gonna slightly drop a little bit, lock into place, and then when you open the door, it slightly lifts, so you can slide it out. This is the main accessory you're gonna use. This is our standard holder for two SCBAs. Just slides over the top like that. What you would have here is a SCBA on this side, SCBA on this side, and your mask here, if they're still connected, to wash. That will go in like that. There's two other connectors, or accessories, that are available. We call this our gear holder. This will be what you load your boots, helmets, and gloves in. So, boots will go upside down, toes pointed in. When you rinse, or when it rinses, these sprayers at the bottom have a shallow spray. It's gonna get about the 1 or 2 inches of your boot wet on the inside. So we always say, once you take them off, it's best to dry them upside down so the water doesn't seep back up into them. That's always good. Gloves can go on here just like that also. Helmets can pretty much go in here however they'll fit. I've seen people put one on this side with the outside open, so it can get to the inside where all the fabric is. That's where a lot of the dirt and stuff is gonna be anyway. But you can take this out and place the helmets in the best way they'll fit. We're developing an insert for that. We have one for the European style, but we're working on one for the American style helmets because they're so much larger.
So much better.
Yeah. So this is called our jumbo holder, which is really to hold like larger tanks. Over in Europe, but what it's really good for is if you want to wash two things at once. Let's say you want to wash your boots, helmet, your glove over here, and then you want to put your SCBA on this side. Just hold the straps on the sides, and then you got place for a mask on either side. So you could basically take off all your gear, wash it in here, and then take it out. So the one you're going to use the most is this. We'll load a couple of SCBAs here in a second. I just want to go over the rest of the functions here. So, basically, what you're going to find is when you come in the morning, the unit should be in standby mode. The lights here will be off. The display would also be blank. The power must have just came back on or something. Usually the display will be blank. And what you do is, to start it up, we want to press the function button twice. If we press it once, it'll light up the display, but it won't start anything. So we press it twice to get it to start to fill. That's gonna start the filling and the heating cycle. What it's gonna do is it's gonna fill up automatically for that sensor that's right in here. And then it's gonna heat up automatically also. While it's filling, you'll notice that the lights will flash right here in the front. When it starts to heat, we're going to see the display flash as it heats up. And that display will flash whenever it's heating, whenever the heater's engaged. So even during the wash cycle, it'll flash.
Okay.
Usually the filling and heating will take between 15 to 30 minutes, depending on what your water pressure is and how cold the water is.
Wow.
So I think you guys have hot water here. It's not super hot, but it's hot enough. Since you have Scott equipment, we're going to be setting the temperature at 104 maximum. So it's within the spec that they set. As long as the red light's on, you don't want to open the door. There's a couple of safeties. If you were to open the door, it's going to give you an error code. If it's washing, it's going to not splash out on you. It's going to basically shut the machine off. So what we do to reset our errors is we want to press the stop button to clear it, and then we want to restart. So over on this side, you got what's called a wall manual. It's basically a cheat sheet for you if you forget how the process works or what steps where. So basically we say here we need the power to be on. The indicator that the power is on is at that red light on the red light here will be on, even if the display is blank. So as long as that red light's on, you know you got power. We want to make sure the drain is closed. That's the manual drain down here in the front. So that's this drain here. So what happens if the drain gets open? That's also going to give you an error code. So you want to clear it, correct the problem, and restart.
So that drain is when you go to clean the water off?
Yes, sir. That's where you're going to go to drain it out once you're ready to dump the water and start fresh. We got pictures, but we also have words. So we say close the drainage valve. Some raw handle in the front, close the door, turn the main power on. To start the filling process and the heating, we press the function button twice to fill the machine with water and heat the tank. So that's just to remind you what to do. Then you've got basically some standard configurations of the equipment. The basket shows a single cylinder, two cylinders, or two SCBAs. Then it shows how to load your helmet, boots, and gloves. Right here, emblems on the helmets. We recommend if it's a natural leather that you don't put it in. If it's metal or like synthetic leather, it should be fine. But the natural leather may warp or something like that, so you can take it off if you need to and wash your helmet with a natural one. Let's see. Here we got basically just shows you how to load the machine once you have the basket filled, how to select one of the cycles, and once you select one of the cycles, the red light will be on, it'll start washing. Once it's done, green light comes on, it'll say end, and that's when we can unload it and load another SCBA. We'll show that here in a minute also. Standby mode is basically at the end of the day. You just want to press the red stop button, and that'll put it in standby. It'll the display will eventually go out about 30 seconds later. And you can leave the water in this as long as it's clean enough to still wash with. So what we recommend is a weekly cleaning, because basically fire stations, we don't anticipate you using the machine a whole lot. Basically, one tank of detergent is 2.5 gallons. We say that would last about a month on basically if you washed 40 SCBAs a week. So that's probably way more than you're going to wash in a week. But that's basically how I would use. So about, and that's assuming that you clean it once a week. So let's say you wash two SCBAs on Monday, you want to just leave the water in there, wash a couple more on Wednesday, then Friday, end of the week, go ahead and drain it out, and you can either leave it empty or you could go ahead and fill it back up and be ready for the next time. We have instructions here on the weekly clean. Basically, you want to stop the unit, drain it out with the manual drain at the bottom. We take out all the parts that are inside, the tank grid. You don't necessarily have to wash them out of sink. You can just take your hose and wash them inside the machine. It's usually easiest because you have to rinse the surfaces also. Then it's basically just wiping down any visible dirt or debris that's in the machine. Like I said, you can use a wet vac to get down into the drain portion where the sieve is, because you'll get grass and rocks and stuff in there. Let's see. Then you put everything back. You don't want to use any detergent because that can cause foaming, like your washer at home. You put dish soap in it or a fountain that gets dish soap put in it, it just foams out. So we don't want that. Only thing you have to do once we're done washing the SCBA is if you have your mask in there, is we recommend you take the mask off and rinse it. That's a picture here. That's with plain water, and then let it air dry. Just because on the inside, sometimes you'll get water stuck in there, but this is a bit upside down. There's most common error codes are listed on here. Door switch, drain valve not closed, the basket drive, shaft stuck. If something gets stuck physically in the rotation, it'll stop. Most common error codes are listed on here. Door switch, drain valve not closed, the basket drive, shaft stuck. If something gets stuck physically in the rotation, it'll stop and give you an error for that. And also 132, that's the level sensor needs to be cleaned. When we're doing the weekly cleaning, we do recommend you wipe off that sensor that's right in the front, just so there's no grease or anything on it. That can sometimes impact the sensing on it. But it will give you an error code if it thinks there's a problem.
Right now, what we're doing is we're filling it with water. So there's two tanks on this unit. There's the tank that's in here, the wash tank. There's also the rinse tank that's on the side here. Sort of illustrate what's going on here. When you first start up the machine, it's gonna run the rinse pump. That's what that sound is. It's rinsing through that valve and the fill and rinse valve or line in there. The pump is gonna stop briefly once it empties the tank. And it's going to, you're gonna hear another noise. So you hear the sound of the rinse pump when it's filling up and also when it's rinsing at the end of the cycle. Okay, you see how it stopped and we hear a filling noise over here? That's the sound of the water filling the rinse tank that's over here. That tank also has a heater in it that heats up the water. So you're not just getting fresh water, you're also getting hot, heated water. And basically the water goes in that tank and it gets pumped into the inside of the unit. So it only comes through that one place. So once that tank fills up, we'll hear the rinse pump start again. It's normal for the rinse pump to stop at times, especially if the water pressure is low or if you get low, if the water gets turned off or something. I think it just finished filling, so we're almost there. So it's gonna top it off and then we'll start to see it heat up. So if it starts and stops, you hear these noises, that's fine, that's normal, especially during the filling cycle.
How long did you take to wash, 10 minutes?
You're gonna have a 3-minute cycle here and an 8-minute cycle. There's no technical difference between those cycles, just the time, the length of the time. It's gonna rinse with the same amount of water at the end. It's just gonna run for longer on the other one. So we recommend using the 8-minute cycle for your SCBA is 3-minute cycle for lightly soiled goods. So if your SCBA is not super dirty, you can also use it for that. The reason it gave us an error here is because the machine is smart enough to know it takes a certain amount of time to fill up. And since I've been starting it and stopping it, it thinks, hey, there may be a problem. Check out the sensor just to make sure there's no issue. Since we know what the issue is, we don't have to check it.
Shut it off, turn it back on.
Press the stop button. Yeah, turn it back on.
Perfect.
Jake's got that one down.
There you go.
Yeah, it's fine. Go.
So,
that's the warranty.
So that 132 error will pop up for a couple reasons. One, if you've stopped it from filling mid-cycle, sometimes that'll do it. Also, foaming issues can cause that. We'll go over three types of foaming. We have major foaming, minor foaming, and intermediate foaming. And I'll explain what those are. Those are the main issues we have, especially when we start up a machine, because the equipment you have has been washed probably, but probably not washed very well. It's probably been washed with Dawn dish soap or Simple Green or something that's really a foamy agent. So usually when I first install the machines, I recommend don't even use the detergent and let it just wash with plain water to sort of rinse everything really, really well. And we'll see when we put these in that there's gonna be a lot of residual.
Why should we black?
Yeah, possibly. A little bit about the detergent. A detergent will pump through this pump here. As you see right now, the pump, the light is not on. Whenever the rinse pump is running, the detergent pump will run, because whenever we put water in the machine, we also want to put a little bit of detergent in also. So that keeps our volumetric consistency the same. So we're dosing by volume of water compared to detergent to keep it sort of even, because you will get an overflow at each cycle down that overflow drain. As it adds fresh water in, that water level is going to rise and it'll overflow down the drain.
Got your drain in the back there. Let's see. Right now you see our displays flashing, so we know that our tank is heating up. We're gonna heat up to about 104 degrees and it'll shut off. Once it gets heated up, the green light will come on. And during the, you'll notice when we wash the cycle, at the end of the cycle when the rinse pump comes on, this detergent pump will also come on. If it's turned off, there's a, you can push down on it to turn it off. You can also push up on it to put it in auto dosing mode. So right now I had it off. When it's off, the green light will flash. When it's working, it will be pumping, obviously, and the green light will be solid. And we'll see that here in a minute.
Is that thing smart enough to know that that's off?
No, it just basically sends power to it. So whenever the pump gets power, it sends power there. Yeah, it comes off the machine. So there's no sold-out function for the detergent. That's why I put it somewhere you can see it. So we'll put it right up there. And then as it goes empty, you just take the cap off and put it on the next bottle. During this time, I usually go with questions. Any questions about basics of how it works or anything?
If you open this right now, will it stop heating? Or can you stop loading your SCBA?
This is the one exception to when the red light is on, you can open it because it's heating. Basically, it's like it's in between cycles.
So you can load it right now?
Yeah, I can load it right now. And then, but it won't let you start the cycle until it's fully heated. Yeah. So you can actually go ahead and load it. You can hear it. And that's so that between cycles, when you're loading and unloading, it will continue to heat. But in those cases, the lights do go off. And I can get them to come back on. one thing this machine does not do is it doesn't disinfect. So that's been sort of an issue with the COVID concerns. What we're recommending is we've been working really closely with MSA. So MSA has a disinfectant that you can spray on afterward. To basically kill anything that's not killed by the wash process. You guys may want to ask Scott if they have something similar, like a quaternary sanitizer, that's all it is, that you just spray on and make sure anything alive is dead. But with that said, the idea is that if you wash your hands, it kills it. If it washes in here, I would assume it does that as well, but we can't legally say that it does, so, you know.
If you sprayed it with spray everything with like a 10% bleach solution, would that foam up the machine?
I would say do it afterward and let it air dry.
Yeah, like afterwards, yeah. Would it foam the machine up?
Now bleach doesn't have a foaming effect, so I would be more concerned about your rubber and things like that. But I think most of the SCBA manufacturers approved that. I think that's what they were doing for Fairfax, using a bleach solution, because they stopped you guys from using it with some type of iodine or something else that you guys were using. It became illegal or something like that, I don't know.
Oh, perfect.
But that Fairfax, they started using 10% bleach, like you said, to disinfect things. One thing you want to be careful of is other detergents. So we'll cover is foaming now. Basically, three types of foaming. Minor foaming is going to result in a noise that, I got a video here, you can hear it. Basically, it's just the pump will cavitate. It'll make sort of a groaning sound.
Are you guys the only ones we can buy the soap from?
It's made by a manufacturer in Texas. So it's the only soap approved for the machine right now. So Ecolab and Diversity didn't approve anything for it yet. But in the future, there may become more detergents available.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'll get you guys hooked up with the place. They've already shipped one case.
Yeah.
And they'll ship you the future ones. Okay. So you hear that noise? That's the sound that'll make when you have minor foaming. Minor foaming is fine. Basically, that just means that foam or air is getting sucked into the pump. It's making some noise. It's not going to hurt anything. It's minor as long as all you hear is a noise and there's no errors, then that's a minor case and there's no need to really do a whole lot to stop it unless you'd like to. One thing you can do when you have minor foaming is you'll experience that a lot when you're first washing your packs because they've got residual junk and gunk in them and soap and things like that. One thing I recommend is when you're first washing them, especially wash them with just the plain water, leave the detergent pump off.
and run the short cycle. What you do is if you run the short cycle multiple times, that's going to add more water into the system more frequently. So it'll help to sort of flush out some of that foam and drain it down the drain. So that's a good way to deal with minor foaming. If you have intermediate foaming, that means that you have the noise plus you have an error code associated with it. It means it's not finishing the cycle for whatever reason. One thing that can happen is if there's enough foam, it can drain it all down the drain. And what that does, that drops the water level. It could give you a 132 error, possibly. It also could give you a couple other errors that are detailed in your service or your operator's manual. I gave her a printed copy, and there'll be a digital copy I'll email to you. Intermediate foaming means that you got the noise and you got an error code, but we don't have any foam coming out. If you have foam coming out, that's major foam. That's when you need to stop the machine immediately, press the stop button immediately, stop it. And then, for intermediate foaming, what I would say is use that same method. Try washing it on a short cycle to see if that presses it out better.
Get rid of it, just manually drain it. If it's major foaming or intermediate foaming, just open the valve, drain it out, rinse it out with a hose.
I would say first, if it's intermediate foaming, I'd say first reset your error and restart it, and then try running your short cycle a couple times. Instead of running 1 8-minute cycle, run 2 or 3 3-minute cycles. That'll help to rinse it a little bit, and that'll probably get rid of the error. If that doesn't fix it, then what you want to do is, like you said, drain it out. We'll turn the detergent pump off, and then we'll fill it up with just plain water and let it rinse really well. So what I recommend is your packs here, I would probably at first just run them all through with plain water and just wash them about 2 or 3 times to rinse them out really well. And then once they're all rinsed, then drain it out, turn your detergent pump on, and then wash them with some detergent as well. You'll get some additional cleaning out of it there. Major foaming, if you got foam coming out the front of the machine here, that's always stop it, drain it out, make sure the detergent pump's off, and then fill it up with plain water and rinse everything really well. Once you rinse everything really good, then you should be fine. It's usually easier in stations, because once you get everything baseline clean, then it's sort of just keeping whatever the last fire is off of it. We have more issues where places like their service, like we've been recently putting them in at service places where they service SCBAs, so they never know what they're getting in, or they're always getting any of the dirtiest equipment possible. So yeah, they tend to have more foaming issues because they don't know what's been used to wash it in the past. Alrighty, we're almost up to heat. Let's go ahead and grab these SCBAs and I'll show you how to load them in here. I'll let you guys do that. I'll take one, put it right in there.
Well, it is on low.
Yeah.
Do you put the regulator in it small, or do you leave it open?
Yes. Here, let's open it. Put the regulator in the mounts. Scott packs are pretty good about leaning in here really well, so I usually don't put the straps there. Normally I just put the straps on the side. If you're having a problem with it moving or like falling this way, you can always put them around there to make it a little more secure. Your mask can go here on the side. And then go ahead and slide it in. Cool. Then close the door. Then just press either one of the. Here you go. So you're gonna hear a pulse. That's just it's just equalizing the temperature because of the cold. Then it'll start washing. That's the noise from the wash. If you make a mistake early, like you push the wrong button, you don't have to stop it. You can always select a different cycle and just start over the count. There's no physical timer, there's no timer on its own, so we just suggest, go do something else, come back. Once it's done, we've got a display end right here. It'll flash in until somebody opens the door. So if you come in, you see if it's in, it's clean, it's clean, it's the cycle, and it's ready to be unloaded and reloaded.
So
What it's going to do is it's going to wash for about 7.5 minutes, and then for 30 to 45 seconds it's going to rinse with the full volume of water in that rinse tank inside. So you get about a rinse of about 1.2 gallons of water. Down here at the bottom, you can see we have our manual drain. There's also two overload sensors here. Those are for the heaters. There's an overload for the heater, overload for the rinse tank heater also. Those probably won't be an issue for you. Only time those trip is when you have like a scaled up a heater or damaged heater or something like that. That's probably a problem way down the line. We always say if you can't reset it and then if it reoccurs, then the call for service. So during the first cycle, these machines are already pretty warm on the inside, if you sort of watch it a little bit. But during the first cycle, you usually see the temperature drop as normal because it's sort of cold on the inside. After that first cycle, it's going to maintain the temperature and then it may creep up a little bit as it washes because the pump's going to generate a little bit of heat. Back here in the back, you may see some foam or some water go down because that cap has holes in it. So you will see a little bit of water come out the drain during the wash, but that's normal.
This whole unit can get wet though, no matter what, right?
So that
you can spray this whole unit down?
No. You don't want to wash it or anything with a hose or anything like that. Just wipe it down. Just wipe it down outside, a little bit of polish. I'll let you some polish there, stainless polish. So yeah, usually just polish outside, inside just wipe it with a wet cloth or a scrub brush and hot water. Now with this, we'll take a look and see how dirty the water is. So that's the sound of folding. And it's minor, so we have noise, but we don't have any air codes, and we don't have anything coming up in front. So like I said, that's usually normal, especially on dirty tanks. So we say that the machine is probably about 95% more effective than hand washing.
So we have like a lemon scent, so they all smell good.
Maybe if you have the sanitizer on it, maybe. Some thing to consider is how do you tell if you got an intermediate foaming problem?
You get an error code.
You might get a noise. But sometimes people don't necessarily make a connection. They're like, okay, well, maybe something else went wrong. The best way to tell is to, when you're in the middle of the cycle, just go ahead and open the door and stop it. If you see the foam level is really high and it doesn't like go down very quickly, then like this, then that's usually a sign you have an intermediate foaming problem. Just a way to confirm it, sort of.
And then
so you see here, we're flashing on the pump because it's not turned on. When we turn it on, we'll notice that it's solid and it'll also start to rotate. It'll rotate just like that. So right now we just leave it off. So whenever the rinse pump's running, we hear it rinsing, it's gonna send power to that pump, it's gonna pump a little detergent in. So what happens when you get the detergent, we'll just need to drill a small hole in the top and put that tube through and drain it out and then let it fill up with the pump on. And as it fills up, it'll prime and everything, we're good. So as you notice, our green light hasn't come on yet. What it's getting ready to do is going to add some more water. Sometimes that foam kicks out a lot of water, so it's going to have to add some more water to get it back up to the level. So it should go green here. There we go. All right. So you said end. So it's going to stay doing that until we open the door. That's how you know it's done. Take these off and we'll get you up on the inside. You don't really smell that bad.
That's what
you look like. That's just with plain water.
A little swampy.
So you can kind of see how you can sort of not see that plug in the back, but I can still see it. So
you can do one more cycle.
You can do a couple more. Probably I'd say three or four more. It's not really that dirty. I can still see the heater. Yeah. So these aren't the dirtiest I've seen by any means. So, but that definitely illustrates to you how much is going to get off
even when you can't really tell if they're dirty physically or not. Here we would drain the machine, clean it out. When you drain it, you want to stop it first. If you don't stop it, it's going to give you an error when you open the drain. So we'll stop it. Drain it out. Then once all the water drains out, rinse it out, all the surfaces, anything the residual, scrub it off, and let it go down the drain.
I guess that is pretty good. Oh yeah, you want to start.
Definitely got a bathtub ring.
Yeah, for sure.
Rinse it out, all the surfaces. That's pretty much it. That's cool.
Oh, there you go.
What else? So far as maintenance, we recommend every 20 months, about 2 years, to do a maintenance on it. That kit costs about $75 for the parts, and then it'll take about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours to do the labor.
New wheels, or?
What we do is replace the O-rings on the center shaft. That shaft pulls out, we replace the O-rings on it. We place a gasket that's in here on the bottom of the door. You can feel it, you can't really see it. I think these gaskets you replace also. So the nozzles here do come off. You really don't have to take them off unless there's something visibly stuck in them. And then you can sort of take it off and unjam it and put it back. It only goes back one way, slot it, so you don't put it back wrong. They don't have to be replaced because they're very durable. Only if one breaks or something like that. And that's pretty much it. It's already set. There's controls up here. So if we ever needed to adjust it, I could walk you through it over the phone. You need to have a precision screwdriver. And then we have the off down here, and then the turn it on and just push up on it. So I'll just leave it in off position for now.
Should that normally be off?
I would say after you've washed everything with plain water, go ahead and turn it on. You probably leave it on. It probably will never get turned off again unless you have a foaming issue. Yeah. Did very well. Right on that surface, that roof leg, you see there's a grate. That's basically an intake of the pump right there. There's a cover there that keeps anything large from getting into the pump. But you can take a look at it. If there's grass or something, or I usually check it if there's a plastic bag or something stuck in there. You don't usually get that with this type of equipment. Right. Intake for the pump or anything stuff. You usually see it pretty good from this side.
Yeah.
So like I said, long handle brush. If you see some stuff on it, just brush it off or vacuum it up with a lift vac.
That's that.
All right. Okay. Yeah, if you're not going to use it for long periods of time, it's okay to just let it air dry for about a day. Then you can close it up after that.